This is a quick video to show you how to dynamically retune Kontakt using Max MSP. To do this, we're going to use a poly. If you've not used a poly before, I'm not really going to go into depth about how they work, but I will cover some of the basics just so we can get the project up and running. Now, I made a patcher earlier for this, so this should start straight away. And we're going to use 16 voices. I'll get back to why we do that later. So straight away, we're going to make our ins and outs. And I know that coming in here is going to be a MIDI message with pitch and velocity. So we're going to do an unpack. I know that later on, our velocity is just going to stay the same. So I will put repack that straight away. And after this, we're going to have a MIDI format. And we don't need these right now, so I'll just put these to one side. What we're going to do for the purpose of this tutorial is we're just going to add a pitch bend factor to our MIDI note. And that pitch bend factor is going to be a number between 0.5 and negative 0.5. That being a quarter tone in either direction. So I'll just have a test number here. Now, Kontakt is individual in the way it handles pitch bend messages because it actually has 100,000 steps per semitone. So what we're going to do is we're going to create one big number that contains our MIDI note and those steps. So we're going to times this by 100,000. Is that right? Yep. And then we're going to round it just to be safe. So just so you can see exactly what's going on at this point, our MIDI note comes in the top, looks something like this, and out the bottom, rookie error. And our MIDI note pops out the bottom. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to transmit these messages over using control change. So we're going to basically sort that out now. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add 50,000. This is so we can send negative numbers to Kontakt. So if this was this value, it can go to Kontakt all the same. But it gets transmitted as a positive number, and then we deal with it later when we're on Kontakt, as you'll see. So from here, basically, I know that all my numbers are now contained within this one integer. So we're just going to take the ASCII values of those numbers to get our control change messages and our MIDI note numbers back out of it. You could do this with maths, but here I thought that this is the easiest way. This is how I've always done it. So basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna pack it two integers at a time. Turn it back into an integer. And then the thing that comes out the bottom of here is a symbol. So we just need to go from symbol. So now you'll see if I do this, it's still MIDI note 69. And we're going to repeat this for the next three as well. And lastly, this one doesn't need a pack because it's just on its own. And then we're going to make the CC messages. Now, I've always done it with these numbers, but you can use whichever ones you want depending on your project. I chose these because I don't think they're used for anything important. And I'll show you how to change this in the Kontakt side as well. So now, if I just put a print here, and you can see when I send my number, I get 62 because it's plus 50,000, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Great. And lastly, we just need to connect everything back up. So this goes here, can delete this. These three go here. Now, the last thing we need to do is we need to sort out the channel number. Now, the reason we need to change the channel number is because to get polyphonic microtonal tunings, we need to have a different pitch bend value per MIDI note. So the idea is that one MIDI note comes in here, it's got its own channel and its own pitch bend value, and then the next MIDI note message goes to a different instance of the poly. This is why we do it this way. And it's really easy to get the channel number. All you need to do is you need a this poly and a load bang. Now the thing that comes out of the bottom here is the instance index of the patcher, which is super useful for this stuff. And lastly, just so everything's clean, we're going to send a busy message to our this poly. That'll stop multiple MIDI notes coming in on the same channel. There it is. So that's our poly. And now we're just going to reload the poly and connect everything up. And if you've not used a poly before, Target Zero is your best friend. And then just so it doesn't do stupid stuff, I'm going to set the minimum and the maximum. Cool. Now on to Kontakt. If you've never done Kontakt scripting before, I'm really not an expert, but I do know a few things, and I'll go over what I know during this little tutorial. So our scripting editor is here. I've already got it open. And we're going to do our scripting in this empty slot. Now, I've found whenever I've done this, and I've done it with quite a few Kontakt instruments at this point, but I found that whenever I put my script into this, the first instance, the first script, it never works for some reason. I don't know why. I can't tell you, but it never does. So always pick one of these four. You may find that these slots aren't empty, and I will go over what you need to do with non-empty slots as we go along. But if there's an empty slot, by all means use that one. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to say on init. This is as Kontakt initializes. And we're going to declare some constants. So we're going to declare LuTune. And we're going to declare polyphonic drive tone ID. This is the, I believe this is the ID of the, or this is to do with the sample ID. And it's polyphonic, so it can select loads, I guess. Now, if you're doing this in a script that is, if none of your scripts are empty and you need to put all of this code into another script, don't rewrite these tags. Find where they are in the script and paste your code within them. Probably at the bottom, and you can do comments and stuff. I'll show you how to do comments, they're pretty easy. Just like that. Paste your code within them, just so, because I don't think it recognizes multiple instances of on, init, end on. I think it just recognizes the first one. But if you find that your Kontakt script doesn't contain an init or some of the next few, you just have to write them. But if they're already there, use them. So our next is on note. So whenever a note happens, our dry ID is going to be equivalent to our event ID, which is basically your MIDI note. Cool. And the change tune parameter, which takes three arguments. So if the change tune function features elsewhere in one of your Kontakt scripts, the easiest way to find this is to basically highlight all of the code, open it in a separate text editor, and do a command F or a control F. So if the change tune function is used elsewhere, you need to make sure that this is set to 1. Basically, our 0 instance of the change tunes, which will always be the first one that Kontakt finds, is our master tuning. And every other change tune function needs to have this set to 1 so that it acts as a slave, basically. So this is our 0 and everything else needs to be 1. So it adheres to our tuning parameter sent in from Max. And lastly, on controller, if our CC number equals 119, if you're going to change the CC numbers, make sure that this is the one furthest to the left. Make sure that this is this one here. Just for data flow purposes. Lutune is equivalent to CC 119. This is the maths that we could have done in Max, but we didn't do. CC 119 times 1000 plus CC 118 times 10 plus CC 117 minus 50,000. Now this first three bit basically adds all of our three CC values together, and our last bit takes away the 50,000 that we added in the poly, so that we get our minus numbers back. And then you just end the if. And then we do end on. And we're done. And it should say here that the script update with no errors. And then you should be ready. So I've connected my MIDI controller now, and I had a bit of a problem actually. And to troubleshoot problems, it's really easy. You just type in a message. And for us, we're going to look at Lutune. Obviously, you can name this variable whatever you want. I just call it Lutune because I know nothing else is called Lutune. And you'll see now that, let's say I make this 0.12345 again. I haven't applied my code. So we're getting the pitch bend value 12345. And then that's that. Obviously, you can be a bit more creative with this if you want to. I just made a very simple version. And if you do want to be more creative, basically all you need to do is replace this bit. And you'll be fine. Cool. Good luck. I hope you have fun microtuning Kontakt. See you later.